We discussed the figure of speech euphemism in our previous part of lecture. Now we shall go ahead with the next type of figure of speech, which is called irony or sarcasm. Now, irony, you are familiar with, occurs when what actually happens turns out to be completely different from what would be expected. You need to understand this. Irony is used to. Irony happens or occurs when what actually happens turns out to be completely different from what would be expected. Means we expect something and something else happens. So that is what irony is. When we talk about irony in writing or speaking, it involves using words so the intended meaning is the opposite of the literal meaning. We use it in our day-to-day language. In Marathi, we don't really want to say that thing. The intended meaning is different from the literal meaning. It is opposite of the literal meaning. So that is what irony is, or sarcasm. In Marathi, we call it upahas. And there are three types of irony. The first one is dramatic, second one is situational, and third one is verbal. Now, what is dramatic irony? Let's try to understand. Now, while watching a movie or while watching the play, a drama, irony occurs. And it occurs when the audience knows more about what is going on than the characters. For example, you are watching a movie and you see that something is going to happen as an audience, but the character on the screen does not know that. So it can create suspense as the audience wait to see if the characters will realize. Now, for example, a villain is hiding to attack the character. You can see that the villain is there and you wait if the hero can save himself or not, or the heroine can save herself or not. So dramatic irony creates suspense because the audience waits to see if the characters will realize what is happening before it's too late. So in stories, generally, where the narrator is in control, it is called an omniscient narrator. An omniscient narrator often uses dramatic irony as a literary technique. Now we shall see some examples of dramatic irony. If you are familiar with William Shakespeare's play, Macbeth, Macbeth is the title character. Means there is a character named Macbeth. So the title character appears to be loyal to Duncan, the king. We think that he is loyal to the king. However, Macbeth is actually plotting Duncan's murder. And Duncan does not know this. But we know that Macbeth is planning to kill Duncan. So this is an example of dramatic irony. Okay, so Macbeth, Duncan thinks that Macbeth is loyal to him. Loyal means he is not going to cheat him. He is honest with him. But we know as an audience that Macbeth is not loyal. Rather, he is plotting Duncan's murder. And the character, the king Duncan, doesn't know this. So this is an example of dramatic irony. If you take another example from George Orwell's very famous allegorical novel, Animal Farm. So in this particular story, the animals believe that Boxer was sent to the hospital. Boxer is one of the characters. That is an ox. Boxer is the name of an ox in the story. Ox or bull, we say. And the animals in the story, other animals like horse, donkey, or whatever other animals, believe that Boxer was sent to the hospital. While we readers, we are the means when reading the story, we know all along that the pigs actually sold him to the slaughterhouse. Boxer was sold to the butcher, to the slaughterhouse. He was going to be killed by the butchers. So this is again an example of dramatic irony. The animals think that Boxer was sent to the hospital. Now, this use of dramatic irony heightens the audience anticipation, hopes, or fears. We keep on guessing what will happen while watching the story, a movie or a drama, or reading the story. We keep on saying, oh, what will happen now? What will happen? The suspense is increased. Now, while watching a TV serial, you must have observed your mother or somebody else from your family saying, "Arey, arey, arey, sir, no, sir, he's going to kill you. Take care, he's there waiting for you." So this is what we do after while watching the TV serials, movies, etc. So that is our anticipation, our hopes, our fears. So the use of dramatic irony heightens the audience's anticipation. So when reading the story, the readers wait to see when the main character will catch on. Suspense is building and the pages are turning. So Vitana, what will happen now? What will happen next? So this is the use of dramatic irony. Means the ca in simple words, I can say the characters in the story are unaware of what is going to happen to them, while readers or audience know that. Okay, this is what dramatic irony is. And dramatic irony is a major literary device in storytelling, in plot construction. Another type of irony is situational irony. Means, as you can see, that situation creates this irony. Situational irony takes place or occurs when something happens that is completely different from what was expected. We expect something and something else happens. It is completely different from our expectation. So in Marathi, we often say, "Kai gammatai," means we were expecting something and something else happens then time. So for example, there are certain examples in which these instances of corporate, these instances incorporate some type of contradiction. We'll see some examples. And situational irony, creates a kind of contradiction. And even sometimes it creates certain type of surprise or shock. You need to understand. We do not expect that. Now, for example, in a story, The Story of an Hour by Kate Chopin, it tells the tale of a wife who learned her husband was dead. A wife learns, comes to know that her husband was dead. She felt a sense of freedom. Actually, we expect that a wife should be shocked. But she feels a sense of freedom, thinking about her new life out from under his thumb. And suddenly the husband returns and she dies of shock. So this is what situational irony is. When she comes to know that her husband, she gets the news of her husband's death. And she is happy rather, thinking that she will be free from his control. Maybe he's very torturing husband. But what happens? Suddenly, he returns And when she sees him in front of her, she dies of shock. So this is what situational irony is. So what we understand by situational irony is that in situational irony, there is a turn of events that is unexpected. For example, again, in a story or in a movie, you think that the protagonist, the main character, will defeat the villain. But what happens? The opposite thing happens. Suddenly, the villain kills the protagonist. So this is something which is unexpected. And the story again takes a turn. So situational irony is a kind of, giving turn to the story, twist to the story. Okay, this is what we understand by situational irony. Dramatic irony. In dramatic irony, the characters are unaware of what is going to happen, but the audience or readers know. In situational irony, something else, the event takes place, which is opposite to the expected thing. And now we shall discuss verbal irony. Now, verbal means related to language, use of words. Verbal irony occurs when a character says one thing but means another. Actually, he says one thing, but he does not mean that. He or she means something else. Now we'll see some examples of verbal irony. In these examples, you'll come across bold words. And these bold words are used as verbal ironies. A writer is working on a comedy. The weather has been dreary, situation, making it difficult to craft witty scenes. Upon opening the blind to see dark clouds outside again, the writer says, blind means the curtains. After opening the curtains, what he sees? Great, another rainy day. How wonderful. Now you can see what is expected. A writer is working on a comedy. He's writing a story with happy end. Comedy means the story with happy end. And the weather has been actually very dreary, very unfavorable. And it is difficult to take the comedy scene or a good scene. And he expects that the situation or the atmosphere will be favorable. But when he opens the window curtains, he finds it rainy, therefore he says, great. Wow, khub chan. So this is what verbal actually does not want to say that. Actually, he's sad. He's not happy with that. Now, another example we'll see. A woman giant dog insists on sitting on her when she relaxes on the sofa. She's relaxing on the sofa and the dog jumps on her. The dog climbs on her and she says, I'm so glad I have such a tiny little lap dog. It is not a little dog, actually, it is a big dog. And she says, oh, actually, she is relaxing and the dog jumps on her, climbs on her. So it is an example of verbal irony. Another example, I just love watching the same cartoon 5 times every afternoon. Such a delight. Actually, he's criticizing, the person is criticizing. He sees that somebody is watching the cartoon. Yes, he says, yes, I enjoy watching the same cartoon 5 times every afternoon. It's such a delight. So this is ironical. Oh no, I couldn't possibly eat another piece of cake. So that's why my aunt said as she picked up another piece of cake and started eating it. The auntie, aunt, took another piece of cake and it was rather, before that she had eaten many. And she says, no, I can't eat any other piece of cake. And she picks up. So this is what irony eats. It creates a kind of comic situation, a kind of, humorous situation. So this is what we understand. This is how we understand three types of iron.